In the aftermath of the school shooting in Parkland, Florida, President Trump played a familiar hand in the blame game.
I'm hearing more and more people say the level of violence on video games is really shaping young people's thoughts.
On Thursday, the president hosted a closed-door meeting with video game industry leaders to debate the topic, but is it really still a debate?
No, no more so than Madden football would qualify me to go try out for the NFL Combine.
Video game historian Patrick Scott Patterson has heard it all before.
Back in the 70s and in the 80s with games like Death Race and Berserk, even Space Invaders, even Pac-Man was controversial to some people. I have known and do know a lot of people that are gamers and gun owners, and they think it's just as preposterous as the people who are gamers and not gun owners.
Despite countless studies, there's still no concrete proof that video game violence causes real-life violence. Worldwide data seems to back this up when it comes to spending money on video games. But when it comes to violent gun death rates, the U.S. is 64 times higher. What's different? Not surprisingly, gun ownership. The U.S. is number one by far.
You could take video games away, and it's not going to change anything as far as these types of acts.
That said, keeping young kids away from Mortal Kombat might still be a good idea. But the data shows that in this case, you can hate the player and not the game.